Friends, today let's take a look as to why some people from India resemble the people of Ethiopia in many ways. Well, this happened in the days after the great flood of Noah. Noah had a grandson by the name Cush through his son Ham, who is called Kamadeva in India. Now, according to a tradition among the Ethiopians, that in the days after the great flood, Cush, the son of Ham, traveled with his family up the Nile until they reached the Atbara plain, from where they could see the Ethiopian tableland. There they ascended and built the city of Aksum. Even the great obelisk of Aksum was said to have been erected by Cush in order to mark his allotted territory. And according to the book of Aksum, Cush's son, Ethiopis, from whom Ethiopia got its name, is said to have been buried there. Moreover, Cush also established the city of Merowe in the lowland. Later, he moved to Mesopotamia, and there he built a city named Kish after his own name. There is a mention of Kish in the Sumerian king list. It states that after the flood, kingship descended from heaven for the second time, and Kish became the seat of kingship. By the way, Cush had been very popular in the Near East as well as in India, that both Caspian Sea and the Valley of Kashmir have been named after him. Unknown to many, his son, the biblical Nimrod, is the Lord Shiva of the Hindus. Famous Hindu gods such as Rama and Krishna are all his descendants, known as the Kushites. This is why Lord Krishna is called Kishan, and Rama also had a son named Kush. Here we do see an ancient historical connection between Ethiopia and India. Apart from this, recently I came across an interesting statement made by the Persian historian Al-Tabari. According to him, Kush married a Japhethic woman named Quarnabil. Her genealogy is as follows. Patriarch Noah, whom the Indians call Manu, had three sons, namely Shem, Ham, and Japheth. Japheth had a son named Tyrus, as mentioned in Genesis 10:2. His descendants worshipped him as the god of thunder named Thor. Tyrus married an Egyptian woman named Ni. They had a son named Batawil, and Batawil's daughter was this Quarnabil that Cush married. According to Al-Tabari, she bore him the Abyssinians, that is, Ethiopians, Sindhis, and the Indians. Well, that is one more reason as to why some people from India resemble the Ethiopians to a certain extent. Thanks for watching.